Good day, everyone. Thanks for tuning in, and hope you're all well. As I said before in a previous video, I am planning on doing some upgrades to the sim during the course of this year, hopefully earlier in the year rather than later, but we'll see how time prevails. And there's a series of upgrades that I want to have a look at, and maybe I can talk you through those now and give you a bit of a flavour for what I want to do. Well, the first of the upgrades, and I've spoken about this before, actually is these window cutouts that you can see here. Now, they're actually okay in this view and this, you know, so here and here. But what I don't like about it is the bottom and the back. And the reason for that is because from the camera, you can see the back of the TV and the bottom of the TV. So to fix that, what I'm going to have to do is completely do this panel again, which is basically MDF, and it cuts off just underneath the base here. So I've got to take this piece out and reprofile the window so it's smaller, you know, so it sort of comes in at about here and then comes up at the bottom. So it completely hides this. Keep the same profile through here, I like that, but just trim it back here, trim it back here, and then redo these sort of over cap, this capping that I did. I 3D printed all of that, so redo all of that through there and through there. And then once I've done that, that'll make that look, I think, a lot better, and do that on both sides. It's a bit of a nightmare though, because to get this off, I've got to obviously pull all these off. I've got to pull the TVs back. And then I've also got to pull these front ones off as well to be able to, because this actually tucks underneath. So it's a little bit of work in this, and it'll take me a little while to do. Probably the biggest thing to do is not just the cutout, but it's the 3D printing of all this capping. I can probably retain some of them, but once I get into these curves, because it will change, I'm going to have to re-3D print all of that. So I'll reprofile this in Fusion 3D, and normally I would have taken that to a CNC guy just to cut them out, but it's a relatively straightforward cut, so I'll probably just do this one by hand. I'll take some dimensions and do it that way and do them by hand. It's just the basically, well, there's actually four of them. There's one on the inside and one on the outside that match, you know, they kind of match each other. So that's the first upgrade that I'm going to do. The front pockets is another area that I've wanted to do for some time. And although you probably can't see them too much from the back view there, I don't have any front pockets either here or on the pilot side. And I think from time to time they come in handy, particularly with, you know, checklists and so on, that you, rather than me reaching back here, I can have them in the front pockets or other bits and pieces, and also just to give a bit more realism inside the cockpit here. Don't quite know how I'm going to do those pockets, so if anyone's got any ideas, feel free to let me know in the comments below. I'm just thinking of a sort of a, you know, like a curtain type, you know, that steel curtain roddy type stuff that's stretchable with hooks on the end, and maybe some material, you know, some leather type material, and then just sort of staple that around and, you know, make them like just a pocket basically. But if anyone's got any ideas and good ways to think about doing that, I'd be more than happy to hear your comments and your thoughts. So pockets left and right will be another one. Whilst I don't really see it too much, I think one of the things that I would like to do is do a bit more work on the bezels. Not necessarily from the view point of view, but mainly trying to hide, or hide if I can, a bit more the outer bezels on this front TV. Now,
There is actually a product that you can get that I think it's I can't remember the brand now, but it's a product where you can actually you can put it over the top and hide your bezel a little bit. And if I think about it, I'll put it in the link in the description below. I think that'll be good. Someone else also showed me, or I looked at another video the other week, where you can take out of an LED or LCD or LED monitor, there's a film layer or something, and if you cut that into a strip and put that down on your monitors, apparently it works quite well. So I'm going to play around with that one a little bit, but that's another significant upgrade, is to look to hide the bezel sides a bit better than what they currently are. And I think that'll work quite well once it's done. Another upgrade that I want to do, and I have spoken about this before, is the TVs themselves. Now, fortunately, I have this is a 4K monitor at the front. They're all Samsung TVs, by the way. This is a 4K TV at the front, but the two side ones are running at 1080p. Now, if you think about it, in terms of load on a single machine, and I'm running this one, by the way, at 1080p. So if you think of load, I've got three 1080p's, so I'm encroaching close to a 4K, you know, one single 4K display, but I'm running that in 1080p. So, you know, what I want to do is get two additional 4K monitors. I may get three, but I might keep this one. We'll see how we go. But the idea is to get another couple of 4K capable TVs and actually look to try and run this sim at 2K, not 4K, because you wouldn't be able to do it 4K on each of these. That's basically 12K trying to run off a single machine, which is not going to work. So I'm going to look to upgrade the side TVs and maybe the front, although it doesn't really need it, but at least the sides, both to 4K capability, and look to see if I can run this sim in 2K resolution. Now, if it doesn't work and I don't get at least a 30 FPS continuous, then it's going to look to the next upgrade. And the next upgrade would be the doozy. So, you know, if I get those 4K TVs there and I don't get the 30 FPS running on the 4Ks and I'm still stuck with the 1080Ps to get the minimum 30 FPS, then it's going to have to introduce a second PC to lighten the load, and then run it, you know, perhaps two on one and two on the other to take the load between it all. Now, that'll be an expensive exercise, because probably what I would do is almost replicate the current PC configuration that I have and do it again, you know, so that's a reasonable amount of dollars there, so hopefully I can get away with not having to do that, but I don't fancy my chances. I think that if I want to go to 2K, and I'm running it off a single PC, even though that's a 12900K and 3090 Ti, 32 gig DDR5, and basically all the fruit in between, I'm not sure it's going to do it well. So we'll see how we go. So there we go. That's a wrap of the upgrade. So once again, window cutouts on both sides. On the right side here, as you can see, I want to take away this. Bring this in, bring that up, do it on both sides. I want to put pockets in the front, just for aesthetics more than anything, but also just a bit of practicality there. I want to put some bezels on here just to hide, bezel covers if you like, to hide that a bit better. I want to look to upgrade the TVs, and then depending on how that performs, would be whether or not I need to look to a second PC to run this. And at the end of all of that, I think that's just about it. I'm pretty happy with the rest of it. I mean, another one that I may look to do down the track, and this is not part of the 2023 plan, but would might be to change out the yoke. Again, as I mentioned before, this is, whilst I have this original Satec yoke, it's all been stripped out. There's nothing left of it other than the handle. The shaft itself is all completely new. I just retained the handle because there's a whole dual mechanism behind for the, you know, for the steering and so on, than what you're seeing. So, but I might just look to do proper Cessna ones, and then reconfigure all of that. But I think that'll be a 2024 or later, because functionally it works really, really well. Okay, hopefully that was a bit of an insight on what I'm planning to do in 2023. Catch you soon, and onwards and upwards for the next one. See you later. Bye-bye. So here are the upgrades in no uncertain terms. No, this is shit. Start again.